Hey guys, today we'll discuss about calcium channel blockers. So calcium channel blockers are classified into three groups. So based on their compounds from which they are derived, right? So we have one drug called verapamil that is derived from diphenyl alkylamines, and we have one drug called diltiazem that is derived from benzodiazepines, and we have group of drugs which are called dihydropyridines that include amlodipine, nifedipine, nimidipine and benidipine. So everything ends with dipine. So these are the classification of the calcium channel blockers, right? So the word itself says they are blocking calcium channels. So how many types of calcium channels are present in our body? So there are two types of calcium channels. One is L type and one is T type calcium channels. So L type is present on the heart as well as on the smooth muscles, right? And T-type are present in our CNS. So we are not talking about the T-type calcium channel blockers here. We are just talking about L-type calcium channel blockers. So we'll discuss the mechanism of action. Right. So mechanism of action. Before going to mechanism, how exactly they act, let's understand what happens in smooth muscle whenever calcium enters into the cell. Right. So we have calcium channel. So these are calcium channel here. Within the cell we have sarcoplasmic reticulum, right? So sarcoplasmic reticulum is a source of intracellular calcium. Whenever calcium enters, this will go and stimulate sarcoplasmic reticulum to release the calcium whatever stored. So once calcium enters, it will stimulate the sarcoplasmic reticulum and it will increase the intracellular calcium. When intracellular calcium is increased, what happens? It makes bond between actin and myosin. So it will make bond between actin and myosin and it will allow the muscle to contract. So smooth muscles include blood vessels and other areas like intestines we have, in the uterus we have the smooth muscles, right? So these calcium channel blockers, what they will do? They will block this calcium channel. So if calcium channel is blocked, no entry of calcium, no stimulation of sarcoplasmic reticulum and no contraction of smooth muscles. So if there is no contraction of smooth muscles, where we can use that, right? So let's understand, in blood vessels, we have L-type calcium channel blockers, right? So we have dihydropyridines. So these dihydropyridines are more specific to L-type calcium channels, which are presented in the blood vessel. Means they are acting more, they have more affinity towards L-type calcium channels which are located in the blood vessels. So this one advantage which makes us will not have effect on the heart. So if there is no effect on the heart, we are having effect only on the blood vessel. So we can use it during the hypertension. Well, we have other group of anti-hypertensive drugs, but these have one advantage. These can be used with the patient who is having bronchial asthma, right? Because it's kind of difficult for beta blockers to be used in the bronchial asthma, and we can use it during diabetes mellitus with hypertension, because there are some adrenoreceptors which are located in the pancreas also and they have some effect on the blood glucose level. That is why these are better calcium for antihypertensive drug during bronchial asthma and diabetes mellitus. So we know the effect on the blood vessel. Now what they can cause in intestine? So intestine also have smooth muscles, right? So if there is no calcium entering into the smooth muscle cell of the intestine, there is no smooth muscle contraction. So if there is no smooth muscle contraction, they will have a side effect. Well, not these calcium channel blockers, but generally calcium channel blockers, due to that property, they have constipation as a side effect. Right? So we are discussing only calcium channel blockers which had effect on the smooth muscles till now. So we have other group apart from these dihydropyridines, other two groups which I told earlier, they have effect on the heart. So what will happen if I block the calcium channel of heart? So let's discuss that now. So calcium, there is no calcium entry to the myocardial cell. So there is no contraction of myocardium, right? So they decrease contractility. So if they are decreasing contraction or contractility, which means that is having a negative ionotropic effect. and also they decrease the conduction of the heart. So if they are decreasing the conduction of the heart,
so we cannot use these drugs in AV blocks, right?
And contractility is decreased in congestive heart failure. So we are not supposed to use this group of drugs in the patient who is having congestive heart failure and the patient who is having AV block. So where else in heart condition we can use it? So we can use it during arrhythmias, right? And we can use it during hypertension, I earlier told you. So we can also use it during angina, because it will decrease the stress on the myocardium, right? So these are the uses of calcium channel blockers. So we know one side effect, that is constipation, right? Apart from that, they have some side effects such as gingival hyperplasia. So gingival hyperplasia is caused due to because gingiva is also supplied by blood vessels, right? So if there is a dilation of the blood vessel, so more blood supply to the gingiva and it will grow more. So that will lead to gingival hyperplasia. And we have a drug called amlodipine, which is derivative of dihydropyridine, that will cause specific side effect, that is ankle edema. Right? So if they are causing vasodilation, what will happen? The venous return to the heart is decreased. Whenever there is a venous return to the heart is decreased, that will cause reflex tachycardia. So this is also a side effect of calcium channel blockers. Reflex tachycardia. The word itself clearly understandable. Right. So these are the side effects of calcium channel blockers. So we know already contraindication, they are contraindicated during the congestive heart failure and AV blocks. So this is the story of our calcium channel blockers. Keep following us. Thank you.